This mic right here is the Elgato Wave 3 USB microphone, and I'm going to make it go from sounding like this to sounding like this with the new Wave Link update and a handful of free incredible plugins. And hey, don't worry if you don't have an Elgato Wave 1, Wave 3, or a Wave XLR. Yes, this Wave Link update is big, and it's going to make applying these kind of effects to all of your programs way easier. But you can still use these tips, techniques, and plugins to make your mic sound great in the likes of OBS Studio and even Streamlabs OBS.
Yes, even Streamlabs OBS.
So stick around and let's get that microphone of yours sounding amazing, okay? All right, cans on, and let's do this. So if you haven't heard of the Elgato update to Wave Link, essentially it's allowing you to use VST plugins in your mic chain. This is a big deal because it lets you process the sound of your microphone before it gets to OBS, Discord, your in-game comms, all of it. And because it lets you use VST plugins, which by the way, VST stands for Virtual Studio Technology, it's studio hardware in software form. These plugins let you do things like equalize your voice, giving it more bass and more clarity, or dynamically controlling your voice with compressor or a limiter. You can even use these on your game chat as well if you've got a really loud group of teammates. There's lots of stuff you can do. You can have special effects, you can have reverbs,
you can have effects like this, and you can sound amazing on your stream every day. Hey buddy, stop making fun of me. I've got a case of the wobblies. You haven't got a lozenge or a glass of water, do you?
And before we go on, no, this is not a sponsored video. I'm not being paid by Elgato or anybody. I'm just excited about this update. This is production quality boosts for so many content creators in a way that's very easy to set up. And I think that's a pretty big deal. If by the time you're watching this video, this update has been rolled out, then you just need to update your Wave Link. But if it's still in open beta, I've left a link to it in the description. Once you've downloaded the beta, you have to make sure that you've uninstalled your current Wave Link version and unplugged your Wave device from your computer. After that, install the beta and reconnect once the installation tells you to. Next, we're going to need some VST plugins. I've actually made a link available below, which is a zip file, and it contains all of the free plugins I'm using in this video. And don't worry if you prefer not to grab that, I've also left links to the individual plugin pages if you want to grab them one by one. And as I said before, they're all absolutely free. Most of these plugins will install as VST3 plugins. VST3 and VST2 plugins tend to default to here on Windows and to here on Mac. Elgato have recommended that you set your own dedicated folder for your VST2 and VST3 plugins. To do that, go into Elgato Wave Link, and in the top right corner, you'll see a cogwheel. Click that cogwheel, and under the effects tab, you're going to see where you can choose a folder for your audio plugins. Set it to wherever you want this to be, and bear in mind, when you're installing the VST plugins to this location, it will still default some of your VST2 or VST3 plugins to those locations I mentioned before. What I'd recommend doing is going to those locations after you've installed all your plugins, checking the VST2 and VST3 folders if they're there, moving any of the plugins you recognize that you've installed to your new folder location, and just keep everything in the one place. Once all your plugins are installed, go back to Wave Link, hit the cogwheel, and under audio effects, hit the rescan plugins button. And what that does is scan for the plugins you've installed, and once Elgato Wave Link has found them, it will show them on screen. And while I'm going to show you how to set this up to sound great with plugins, do remember the techniques that can help you improve your mic sound that you don't actually need a plugin to do. Things like the proximity effect, the signal to noise ratio. Basically, getting closer to your mic is giving you a better sound than if you're too far away from your mic and all of your room starting to get into your signal. Steggy over at Elgato did an excellent video covering exactly this. I'll leave a link to it in the description. Do check it out. Alright, I'm going to strip my mic of all these effects and we're going to start building this from the bottom up. Just before we begin, I would highly recommend you download a program called Audacity. I use this for testing the entire set of my effects one by one or all together. And what I do is I set the input to my stream mix so that I can then toggle on and off the effects in Wave Link and hear them in the recording in Audacity whenever I'm listening back. Recording these comparisons and then listening back helps me establish if I'm doing something right or I need to go and fix something to improve the overall sound. For full transparency, I'm going to show you how I've set up my Wave 3 in Wave Link. If you click here, you can see I have set my input gain to 21 dB. I have the enhanced low cut filter on and the clip guard on. If you click this button here, this is where we're going to put our audio effects. At the bottom here, you can see that there is a toggle for the filters on your monitor mix, so you can hear it if you're listening to your monitor mix through Wave Link, how it sounds with and without the effects. And the one that I recommend putting into Audacity, which is the stream mix, you can toggle everything on and off right here, or you can do it one by one by clicking on the speaker icon beside each plugin. So the first plugin up here is Renegade. Renegade is a noise gate. The basic idea of a noise gate is if you're not talking, it's closed, and if you start talking, it opens, allowing people to hear you, but not allowing them to hear below a threshold that you set, which means then it can help cut out things like mouse clicks and keyboard clicks and just general room noise. So if we click on the plus button here, you go to Effect and down to Renegade, go to this cogwheel here, and you can see here visually it's already working. This here is the threshold. If you bring this down to the very bottom, minus 70, and you'll see here when I'm not speaking, there is like a little bit of volume down there. That's my room noise. That's sitting about minus 50 dB. So if I bring this up past that, and you can hear that the noise gate is effectively closed. Now, I actually want to have this up a little bit further. I'm gonna put it about minus 29 for me. I find that if I have it there, my mouse clicks and my keyboard clicks don't come through. Over here, this dot right here, I would recommend just dragging that right down to 100%. And if we move over to the envelope up here, this is basically how quickly the gate opens, stays open, and then closes. So for me, I want the attack to be 30 milliseconds. I want to hold it open for about 70 milliseconds, and then I want to close it within about 20 milliseconds. The softer attack helps with the keyboard clicking and lets my voice still come through quite clearly. Do make sure that it's not cutting off certain words that you're saying, words with softer beginnings like S's or F's. Test it, listen on Audacity, make sure that it's working properly. The next plugin I'm going to add is a De-Esser. This is optional, but I would add it in just in case you feel you need to use it later on. At the minute, you can't drag and drop plugins into different orders, so having these in this order is really important. If we go up here again, go to Effect and click on De-Esser. And once De-Esser is open, you should see this. All we're going to do in here is bring down the threshold of the De-Esser. The way a De-Esser works is it listens for sibilance in your voice, like S's, F's, C's, X's, and it listens for that high pitch sound, and it dynamically reduces it without affecting your overall voice too much. At least that's how it should be. If you find it's making your voice sound muddy, try and reduce the amount that you've applied. I'm going to bring this down to about minus 32. I'm going to set the intensity to 7 and set the sharpness to minus 7. You may not be able to hear how effective this is on my voice, so I'm going to do a really extreme example so you can hear what it's doing to the sibilance in my voice. Hopefully that makes sense. I don't touch any other settings in here for myself, so I'm happy with that. Okay, so the next plugin I'm gonna add is an equalizer, or you might notice as an EQ. An equalizer or EQ is an audio filter that isolates certain frequencies and either boosts them, lowers them, or leaves them unchanged. This is good for rounding out the lower end of your voice, taking room sound or nasal sounds out of the mid range, and adding a bit of clarity into your high end. Go into the plus button again, and we're going to load up TDR Nova. When you load it up, you should see this. You might not see this visual here. If you want to see that, just click the out function up here. And what that means is everything you adjust here, it's going to show the signal how it's affected after you've done your EQ work on it. So the first band we're going to look at is this one here, boosting frequencies in around 110 to around 140, 150 hertz can help you add a bit of warmth and a bit of body to the lower end of your voice. I find that if I set the EQ value here to 1, which basically tells you how tight or loose the band's going to be on the EQ, and then I'll put the frequency to about 115 hertz. You can click here and type in whatever you want, and I'm going to push the gain up to about 3. Be careful not to go too far or you will start sounding muddy. If it does sound muddy, just bring it back a little bit. I like to use the second band to pull out a little bit of the frequency around the 180 to 240 hertz area. This area, for my voice at least, can quickly create muddiness on certain mics, so I like to just correct it a little bit if I can hear any amount of muddiness, especially if I'm boosting this lower end. So I will put it around 230-ish, and I'm going to bring it down not very much, just about 0.5. The third band I like to use to pull out some of the mid-range in my voice. This is good for pulling out nasal kind of sounds or some of the room noise you might be picking up. And I usually put this about 1000 hertz. I'd say about minus 1.5 dB is fine. And I've actually lowered the Q number to 0.5, and you can see that the bend is a lot looser, not as tight as the first band, for example. Finally, I want to boost around the 3000 to 6000 hertz area to put a little bit of clarity into my signal. I'm going to set this around 3.2. I'm going to leave the Q at about 0.6, and I'm going to push this up to 4.5 dB. I'm happy enough with my sound, so I'm leaving that there. The next plugin I'm going to add is an exciter. This is completely optional. I'm adding this to just push in a little bit more presence and a little bit more body into my vocal. Same again, we go up to the plus button and we go to effect and we add La Petite Excite, which if you've done French, it means the small excite. Maybe, I don't know. I did German at school and I failed that as well. So this is the exciter interface. The only two things we're going to look at is the low end and the high end. I'm going to push a little bit into the low, maybe about 0.5, and I'm going to push about 1 into the high end. And that's all I'm going to do with this. Final plugin I'm going to add is a limiter. Usually a limiter is used to prevent a signal from going over a certain level, and they're very good at doing that. They can also be used to increase the overall loudness of a signal, which can be quite useful on vocals. Using this limiter lets me keep the vocal closer to the original sound while still enhancing it for the final touches. Once again, just go up to the plus button, head to effect, and add frontier. When it loads up, this is what you should see. The first thing I want to change is the release. I want to make it fast. Then I'm going to go over to the output level, and this limiter will not let your vocal signal go past wherever you set this. I'm going to set it to about -3.5, and in the threshold, I'm going to bring it down for me to about -8, and I can see on the reduction that it's kicking in there. You want to test this on Audacity, do a recording, tweak the setting, and just make sure it's right for you, because I might speak louder than you or quieter, so everyone's going to be different. If you pull this threshold down too far, you're going to bring up a lot of the noise floor in your microphone, so do be wary of that. I'll show you an example. This is it sitting at -24. This is it at 0. And this is at -8. So I'm pretty happy with that. I'm going to leave that be. And the final plugin, yes, this is the final plugin. Everyone needs this.
And it's vibrato, baby!
This is a vibrato plugin by Melda Production. I've included the files for this in the zip, and I've included a link to their website so you can get their full production suite for free. And it's just an example of one of the effects that you can add into your vocal chain. Hopefully we can toggle these on and off in the future to have some fun with it as well. I hope this video helped. This is such a big deal, having this kind of access to production quality on your microphone before it reaches any programs on your computer. If you enjoyed the video, don't forget to hit the sub and bell, and let me know how you guys are using VSTs, what you find that's interesting, whether it's in Wavelink or out of Wavelink, any favorite VST plugins that you have, I want to know about it, and anything cool that you're doing as well. Feel free to hop into our Discord, say hey, and let's talk about cool ideas and stuff. I'm Defrag. And you and me, we're gonna meet again. Bye.